We got Peking Duk with us. We're here chilling. We're talking about music. We're talking about good hair.
Talking about everything.
Hey, fellas. What's
Hello.
Happening?
Thanks for having us.
How did the name come about?
Well, it came about from
we're out.
The most creative.
You know when you're partying and you're feeling a little.
And we've had a few too many beers. Beers that you sort of eat. And you start peeking.
Say you're at the peak of the night, and you could be having so much of a good time that you start to look like a duck a little
and
bit,
you
like
start
that.
To go up.
And you start.
And
you actually, yeah,
you
that
turn into
a
little bit of a duck from all the beers.
All the peeking. So you're peeking like a duck. And then
it just became something we would say to our friends. We'd be like, oh, look at Brenton. He's peeking duck. Or Davo's peeking duck right now. And so
one night we were sitting there. We were like, well, we've got this music. We need a name now. And at the time, we were peeking like a duck. Yeah. And it sort of made sense. We never thought it would stick or anything. We never... But yeah, now we're here telling you what the name is.
You guys are also prepping for a U.S. tour, which is super exciting. What could you tell the fans about the tour, and you know what are some of the cities you'll be stopping by?
We'll be doing
we're doing L.A., San Diego, Austin, Dallas, Webster Hall, in New York.
Nice, New York, love it.
That'll be sweet.
A few other U.S. shows and a couple of Canadian.
I don't know what we're allowed to
Montreal,
announce.
Detroit.
Yeah,
yeah, and I don't know if we can announce the venues, but we can
it's
at least
be a
say
good
that
time.
We're going to come to those
it's gonna
cities.
Be a very good time.
And
what do we see? I mean, at your shows, I know you guys get a little crazy. You have a little fun.
Yeah.
I've never been to one of your shows, so I just want to know what it's like.
There's a lot of sweat.
A lot of sweat and...
Nudity every
and
now and then.
A bit of nudity.
What?
It's a good time. It's just like a big party.
It's not like there's not any nakedness. But
there's not nakedness.
No.
Reuben gets completely naked. That's what happens.
I actually don't.
No, it's just like a party. We try and make it like a big party and try and get everyone involved.
So I know you guys are working on a lot of new music right now, a lot of collaborations, working with different artists. I know before we started the interview, you were telling me a little bit about who you'll be working with. Anything that you could tell us?
Yeah, we sort of like don't like to announce who we're working with until the song's actually out because, you know, otherwise people get talking type
thing.
But we've got a lot of new music that we're working on at the moment. We're just going to get the album together.
How do you guys know it's a hit when you're in the studio? How do you know, okay, this is a hit?
You don't
really.
Like,
if it sounds really good and you feel something from it, if it makes you feel some type of way, then I guess that's a good thing.
Yeah, if it feels nice to listen to in the car and in the club, then, you know, it's got a couple of platforms there.
Yeah. I don't know. You just sort of know which one to roll with next for sure.
Of course, you're out here in California. You're doing your thing. You're back
out
to,
here in Cali, just doing
Cali
our thing. Just out here lounging.
What's it like being, you know, from Australia, then coming out here, and then seeing all
funny.
The fans reacting to your music?
Well, yeah, we haven't really given a proper tour of Iran yet, so I guess we'll see how that goes when we get to it.
Yeah, I mean, but last year in March it was pretty fun, and the March before that.
Yeah, there were some fans that came out to our shows in South by.
Yeah, some, and also like random towns like East Lansing, Michigan.
Yeah, that was really fun.
Heaps of fans there for some reason.
We ended up going back to a, it was like a frat house.
And
we partied with them until the early hours of the morning, and it was like freezing outside.
There was like snow on the ground, and it was
a great time.
It was really fun.
Yeah. Shout out to East Lansing.
How do you guys feel about like DJs, like, you know, collaborating with rappers and different artists? You know, music has really changed.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
It's awesome. It means there's no rules.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, it's sort of like there is no rules anymore. You can, you know, I mean, like, we're working with people that write just straight rock music type thing, and
yeah,
it's like there's nothing weird about us collaborating with them anymore. It's
yeah, like at first it was like a bit of a different venture, and now it's like it doesn't, like, no one gives a shit.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Are you guys into the studio this week?
We're sort of just traveling around, really. I haven't touched my laptop once since we got here.
Actually, Dylan Francis just asked me what chockers means. Would you understand if I said, yeah, we've been pretty chockers?
I have no idea what you just said.
So it's like our schedule has been chock-a-block packed. You know
it's
how,
been like,
you
it's
know
been
like
full?
Yeah.
You like know how like a chocolate block, it's like, it's pretty tight packed.
You know, Reuben actually woke up with a block of chocolate
in his bed. I woke up, there was chocolate all through my bed. But
what?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was pretty drunk and just found all the Hershey's and just went. Yeah.
That's not the first time that's happened.
I wake up like every other day. How much do you guys love music? How therapeutic is it?
Very therapeutic.
Yeah, it's good to listen to. But it's just as fun to make.
Yeah, it's good to listen to.
It's real good for
listening. You heard it here first. Music is good to listen to.
Music is great on the ears.
Yeah. Yeah, no, we're always listening to music nonstop, all the time.
Totally. All day, every day.
And there's a lot of good new music at the moment, so it's great. You really don't.
Is it cool to date a DJ? Because I have to say, I did go on a few dates with the DJ. They're very busy, though. I don't know. DJs have
my ex-girlfriend is probably my ex-girlfriend because I'm a DJ. Put it that way.
Really?
He's got a girlfriend, though.
My girlfriend, she struggles seeing not much of me.
Seeing selfies with other girls.
and
selfie sticks.
Selfie sticks
with mums. But no, I think it's fine, yeah.
How do you balance it? I mean, how do you balance being on the road and having a girlfriend?
I think it all depends on, like, the...
I think it's just contact. You need to sort of say hi every once in a while.
Yeah.
You know, of course, we want our fans out there and the fans of you download the music. We want them to follow you on social media. We want to make sure that we're getting the music out there. How can we do that?
Just check us out on Facebook, SoundCloud, Twitter, Instagram, everything.
Yeah, on the socials, it's Peking Duk. P-E-K-I-N-G.
Like the old Beijing.
Like the old Beijing. And then
old
Duck.
City.
D-U-K. No C.
We're Peking Duk.
And this is the entertainment scoop.
Scoop. Scoop. Scoop. Scoop.